Welcome to another edition of Chaffee Break. My name, as always, is Maxwell, and today's video is from the user Cash Laundry. That's Cash Laundry, and he's driving the T21 on a standard battle on Westfield. Obviously, this is a tier 9 battle, so really going to have to be using his tank as a dedicated scout. And as you can see, there's quite a lot of light tanks on either side, so it should be a pretty good, fast-paced, action-packed game. Fingers crossed. So first off, just going to be taking a route underneath the viaduct and setting himself up in this little mountainous region here. Just going to speed up a little bit until we actually get into some action. Just spots out the Chinese 5916 there, the tier 6 light tank. Just going to be trying to keep him in his sight so that he can't sneak around the bottom of that town and get some flanking action on the go. But it looks like he's decided against that as they have a heavy tank stationed up there and trying to sneak through the centre here. Underneath the viaduct himself, unfortunately, runs headlong into a tier 9 medium tank and gets himself blown up. So now he's just going to do exactly what that 5916 was planning on doing, which is getting around the bottom of this town and flanking the enemy and trying to get some damage on them from a direction that they're not expecting. Unfortunately, seems to be a little bit stuck on this mountainous region as the T21 doesn't have the best acceleration to get over those humps. But it looks like they feel pretty secure, so they've got a couple of light tanks up on the hill behind those bushes there, but unfortunately they are about to get pounded because they're not expecting the enemy to come from this direction to have taken the central valley so quickly. And this 12T should, there you go, taken out no problem whatsoever. And this T21 hasn't been paying attention, doesn't realise that enemies have snuck up from the flank there and getting themselves shot and deciding to suicide off the edge of the cliff there. No idea what was going on there. Perhaps he didn't suicide but thought that he could get himself over and slide to safety down there. Unfortunately, just dropping a little bit too far and getting himself killed. Just spots out a Yag Tiger that is a little bit out of position. It looks like he's pushed in a little bit too far and is deep behind enemy lines at the moment and trying to get some damage on this T-30. Unfortunately, because he's pushed so far in and so far behind enemy lines, just going to get himself shot. Cash Laundry doing the absolute right thing there, not shooting at the Yag Tiger until he was in very, very close. And the reason for that is if he shot him from a larger distance and managed to get some damage on him, then the Yag Tiger would have known he was coming and would have been able to turn and position himself accordingly. Therefore, probably would have been able to get a hit on him as he was coming in and take him out. And this would have taken a very different turn. Yag Tiger not really sure what to do at the moment. As you can see, he's probably not had very much experience dealing with light tanks. What he should be doing is driving in one direction and attempting to turn on the spot. Even if he hasn't got the traverse speed, it's at least something rather than just driving forward and then reversing backwards and getting himself taken out by this T21. I'm pretty sure he 100-0'd him. So low there, so that's a lot of damage he managed to get on. So now just going to come round and assist their tank destroyer against the M103. Fingers crossed, if the M103 keeps attention on the T30, then our man here, Castellone, should be able to come round and get some good damage on his rear armour. And conversely, if the M103 decides to focus on the T21, then the T30 could just pound him from the front there and get him damaged and taken out. Oh, unfortunately gets his track taken out there. Unfortunately, it looks like luckily, it looks like the M103 hasn't noticed that his track's been taken out, or else he could just swivel that turret round and eliminate him. But it looks like he's got eyes only for the T30 now, and is just trying to take him out as best he can, and the T21 just finishes him off, takes off his last bit of hit points. And there we go. So the battle's pretty even at the moment at 11-11, although one of their guys did suicide, so it's really 4-3. And it looks like the enemy is confined to their side of the battlefield and the allies are confined to their side of the battlefield. So just going to speed it up a little bit until we get back into some action. Spots out the E50 there, but luckily it doesn't look like the E50 seen him as he is heading down into the valley to chase. What is that that's left? That is an AMX 1390. So going to see if the E50 can chase down the 1390. The 1390's probably reloading, which is why he's doing a runner. And now he's been taken out. So they have a heavy tank still. Who is that? That's an IS-8 who's closing in on their base. But it looks like their allied E50 hopefully can deal with that situation, as the E50 actually technically has better armor than the IS-8. The IS-8's not particularly well protected. And the Allied T-30 has spotted out their artillery, so if we take out the artillery, that'll even things up a lot more with that. Ooh, but the E50 is taking, the T-30 is taking a hell of a lot of damage, realizes that he's had it, so he's just going to go in and ram the artillery and make sure that he gets the kill there, and the E50 just coming in and finishing off the T-30. So now it's E50 versus E50 and the T-21 of Cash Laundry. To be honest, going up a hill like this, there's not really much that Cash Laundry can do. What he probably should be doing now is just dropping back and getting some eyes on the enemy base, and there you go. Nothing really you could do about that. The E50 is just a beast and more than a match for a T-21, especially on a slope like this where he couldn't have an opportunity to quickly get away. So what he probably should have done there with 20-20 hindsight is just drop back and get some eyes on the enemy base, or even start a base capture, and then that would force the enemy E50. That would force the enemy E50 to drop back and stop the base capture, or just keep eyes on him from a distance. Then the Allied E50 can come in and take him by surprise. So this one drags on for a little bit just at the end here, as he's trying to decide what to do. Can't decide. People tell him to cap, and he's probably not really wanting to. They've pretty much got the same amount of hit points, so this should all come down to a game of skill. So he's finally had enough, and going off now to cap the enemy base. So that was an absolutely brilliant replay from Cash Laundry. He only picked up 3 kills there, but caused a hell of a lot of damage. Pretty much 100-0'd the Yag Tiger and took a decent chunk of hit points off that M103. And did some good spotting for his team, so really showing that a scout tank can be a good asset to a battle, even at tier 9. What is going on here? It looks like he's lost connection, as he's just sitting facing in the distance there, not reacting to being shot at all. So wow, unfortunate end there for the enemy. Their last remaining tank, which had pretty much even hit points with the Allied tank, has lost connection and going to get himself taken out. So that's pretty much the end of the clip. So thank you very much for sending that one in, Cash Laundry. Brilliant replay there, showing the T-21 isn't a piece of crap like a lot of people think. Thank you to you guys for watching, and I will catch you next time.